When you said that ahead of writing the Ayodhya title suit judgment, you sat in front of the deity and asked what the solution should be. It is in a case where the two sides are actually, they belong to two religions. So how would you please elaborate on both?
Your second question, which was in relation to what I said, I think that's again a problem of the social media, which you know, Apurva just mentioned a short while ago. You must have the backdrop of where I was speaking. I'd visited my village, which is about 1.5 hours away from Pune. It's a village called Kanersar, predominantly agricultural community. And one of the questions which I was asked was that in the arena of conflict which you find in your courts, how do you stay still or how do you stay calm? That was a question which I was asked to specifically, which I was specifically made to answer. I said, everyone has his own mantra. And my mantra, again, I don't mean the religious mantra, but you know, the mantra of life. Somebody may want to exercise, somebody wants to trek. I said, so far as I'm concerned, I spend an hour every morning in reflection. Reflection about what I'm going to do, how I'm going to handle my caseload for the day, how I'm going to handle this arena of conflict in which I perform my public duties every day. And I said that, and when I said that I sit before a deity, I make no bones about the fact, and I'm not defensive about the fact that I'm a person of faith. I have my own faith. Equally, I respect every other faith. And that's the kind of work which we do. My being a person who professes a particular faith has nothing to do about how I will treat people of different faiths who come in conflict and come in court seeking justice before us. So what I answered was that, of course we answer, and this in response to your question, how do we decide cases? And I must put that point against me as well, because, you know, well, people said, well, oh, now the judges of the Supreme Court are appealing to a divine power to tell them the answer to a case. That's really now putting what I said on the head. What I said was this, and what I mean was this. Of course, every case that we decide is decided in accordance with the principles of law and the Constitution. And whether we do that or not is, again, subject to scrutiny. We are going to deliver two judgments tomorrow, and you'll see whether they are decided in accordance with the Constitution and the laws. But having said that, the same judge who applies the law can do justice, but as a human being, there's always a prospect that the same human can commit an act of injustice. You see, in colonial times, the same law was used as a means of oppression. The same law can be used as a means of providing justice. So what is the distinction? How do you ensure that as a human being, you use the authority which is given to you under the law to do justice as opposed to doing injustice? And that's where your own sense of equanimity comes to the fore. How do I maintain my own sense of equanimity in an arena of conflict, intense conflict, and not just conflict between, say, states in the union or between two political parties, conflict between husband and wife, conflict between two warring corporate houses? And that's where I feel that whatever way you adopt to maintain your sense of calm is very crucial to having an ordered discourse and ordered outcomes in the work which you do. And I believe that if someone feels that, well, it's their faith which gives them that sort of calm, because it's that sense of calm which gives you the degree of objectivity to look beyond the conflict, so be it. And I think that people must accept. And the fact that you belong to a particular faith has nothing to do about your ability to do justice to people of different faiths as well. So long as we accept that, I think, and you know, one look at our daily cause list, which incidentally I don't look at because, you know, they're names, but one look at the daily cause list would just indicate the diversity of India which comes to our court every day and to whom we try and do justice.